dear students. So topic for this video is rotational EMF. So till now we have already discussed that if there is a rod which is moving in a constant magnetic field, there will be an EMF produced in that. So in this part, what we'll discuss is that we have a rod, but it is not moving, it's hinged. So it is only rotating. There is no motion, like there is no lateral motion, there is only rotational motion in this. So this rod is fixed at this point. Let's name this point as A and let's name this point as B. Let's assume that the length of the rod is L. There is a constant magnetic field B0 over here and this rod is rotating anti-clockwise with a angular speed of omega. So if I want to find the EMF developed between these two points, how will I do that? So if I see in this rod, the velocity of all the parts won't be same. The velocity of all the parts won't be same. It will vary as I go, as I move from A to B. So I cannot directly use the formula. I need to integrate over here. So what I will do is, I'll take a small element dx, at a distance of x, and I'll write small dv. For this dx element. So if I write small dv for this dx element, what will be the value of that? The value will be v cross b dot l. So v over here is, velocity over here is nothing but omega multiplied by x. So velocity is nothing but omega multiplied by x. This cross b, so v will be nothing but in this direction. V will be in the upward direction and b is inside. So the angle between V and B is 90 degrees. So I write omega x, which is V, into B, which is B naught, sine of 90 degrees, which is nothing but 1. So this is V, this is B naught, this is my magnetic field. This dot product with L. So V cross B will be in the same direction as my length. So I'll simply multiply L over here. So L, okay, so L over here is, for this point, L is not L, L is nothing but dx. So I should write over here dx. So for this dx element, small dv will come out to be omega x multiplied by magnetic field multiplied by this small length dx. And now what I need to do is, I need to integrate it. So if I integrate this part, what will I get? Omega B naught is constant. So I'll get x square divided by 2. So over here, if you see properly, the limit for x will be from 0 to L. Limit will be from 0 to L. So if I put limit from 0 to L, my answer will come out to be omega B naught L square by 2. This is the magnitude of potential difference between A and B. Now over here, what will I write? Will I write VA minus VB or VB minus VA? So for that, we need to look at the direction of V cross B. So my B is in the upward direction and B is inside. So the direction of higher potential is towards A. So over here, I'll write VA minus VB. So this is the direction as well as magnitude of potential difference in a rotating rod. So let's do a question. Let's try this question related to rotational EMF. So over here, we have a rod which is kept in a constant magnetic field B naught, which is directed inwards, and the hinged portion is in the between. This portion is hinged, B point is hinged, and this rod is rotating with a constant angular speed of omega. The length of the rod is L. Complete length is L, and this is exactly in the middle of the rod. This hinge is exactly in the middle of the rod. So there are three parts of this question. First part is VA minus VB. VA minus VB. So how to approach this question? So first thing that you need to do is, you need to identify which one is at higher potential. So over here, if you see, velocity at any point over here will be in downward direction because this is rotating anti-clockwise. So V is in downward direction and B is inside. So V will be at higher potential. V is in downward direction and B is inside. So direction of higher potential will be towards B. So this quantity will definitely come out to be negative. So one thing is clear that I'll get a negative value. Now how to identify the magnitude? For magnitude, we'll directly use the formula. This is nothing but B naught omega, B omega L square by 2. So over here, B is nothing but B naught. Omega is omega L square by 2. So what is L? So L over here will be nothing but L by 2. So I'll write L by 2 square divided by 2. So this is the answer for the first part. Now let's do the second part. Second part asks VB minus VC. So if I look at over here, if I take this C point, the velocity of C point is upwards and velocity cross B will be directed towards left. So B point is at higher potential. That is why this quantity will be positive. This quantity will be surely positive. And what will be the magnitude of this? The magnitude will be same as the above. B naught omega L by 2 square divided by 2. Now over here. So if I ask you what is VA minus VC, if you look at it carefully, both of these points, none of these points are hinged. So if none of these points are hinged, we cannot directly use the formula. In this case, what we need to do is we need to find VA minus VB, and then we need to find VB minus VC, and we have to use those two values, those two equations to find this. If we directly use the formula over here, B naught omega L square by 2, we get a wrong answer. So the important thing which we need to take care regarding this formula is, in this formula, one of the points has to be hinged. If none of these points are hinged, we cannot use this formula. In that case, we have to take a point which is hinged and derive the potentials related to that point, and then using manipulation, we have to figure out the answer. So in this case, what we can do is, we can simply add these two. So if we add these two, what we'll get is, we'll get an answer as 0. Because magnitude is same and sign are different, we'll get an answer as 0. What it means is that this A point and this B point are equipotential. This A point and this B point, these both points are equipotential. So over here, let's do one more question over here. So if I ask you, instead of a rod, if we have a disc, let's take a disc over here. Which is hinged at the center and it's revolving with angular velocity omega. Magnitude of B is B naught, which is directed inwards. So, and if I ask you the potential difference between this center point and any point at the periphery, how will you find it? So the trick for this question is, we can assume this disc to be made up of infinite number of rods. So if I assume this disc to be made up of infinite number of rods, so I can take this part as a rod and directly use this formula. So let's assume that the radius of this disc is R. So VC and VP. So potential between C and P will be nothing but V naught omega R square. In this case, L is nothing but R. R square by 2. This is the magnitude of potential. And which one will be a higher potential? For this, what we need to do is, we need to do V cross B. So let's take this point P. So velocity at this point is in right direction. So V cross B will be in upward direction. That is why C is at higher potential. So what we'll write is VC minus VP. So this is the magnitude and this is the direction. So VC is at higher potential, VP is at low potential. So this is all about rotational EMF. Thank you.